Hello, I am Michael Miller, and I am a piano major in the Bachelor of Music Transfer Program and also a tenor in the GPRC Choir. So our first piece we will be performing is the Franz Schubert's Mass in G Major. Now, naturally, the church mass is typically comprised of five different texts, and we'll be singing the first one, which is the Kyrie. And these texts will have the repetition of Kyrie eleison, Lord have mercy, and Christe eleison, which is Christ have mercy. The Mass in G major was originally written for SATB form, strings and organ. In the middle of this piece is a soprano solo, which will be taken by Melissa Hebert. Then right afterwards, we will have the same text, but in a more contemporary modern setting, and it is written by Andrea Klaus. So the suspensions and close dissonances create the more familiar and modern sense that we are usually used to. So we hope that you enjoy these next few pieces.
Thank you. of the Bachelor of Music program. The next song that we're going to sing is Ave Verum Corpus by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. Mozart was an Austrian composer who lived in the latter half of the 18th century. Although he only lived until the age of 35, he left behind a rich musical legacy and helped shape Western classical music. He was a child prodigy and played multiple instruments, including piano and violin. He was also a prolific composer and wrote in every genre of his day, including opera, piano concertos, chamber music, and choral works. Ave Verum Corpus is one of his choral works. This motet was written in 1791, just a few months before Mozart's death. It was composed to celebrate the feast of Corpus Christi and is a setting for a 14th century Latin hymn. The text is a prayer to the crucified Christ and was traditionally sung during Mass. Since the text is in Latin, I found an English translation to read to you. Hail, true body, born of the Virgin Mary, who having truly suffered, was sacrificed on the cross for mankind, whose pierced side, filled with water and blood, may it be for us a foretaste of the heavenly banquet in the trial of death.
Of Science Transfer Program at GPRC. Now we will be singing two madrigal pieces by Thomas Morley. The first madrigal is entitled Now is the Month of Maying. This piece was written and published by Morley in 1595 and discusses the feelings of spring and dancing in the spring. The second madrigal is entitled Sing We and Chant It. This one was composed by Morley but arranged by Robert Lucas de Parcelles in the late Renaissance period, specifically 1595. In this piece, he focuses on enjoying the short-lived pleasures of friendship and youth, while conveying the light-hearted nature of madrigals. So, here is Now's the Month of Maying, and Sing We Enchant It.
Each with his body loves, a dancing on.
Our next piece is Sleep Now by Matthew Emery. The text, originally written by Irish poet James Joyce, invokes a sense of comfort and peace as the narrator lullabies the reader to sleep. The 29-year-old composer, Matthew Emery, is a Canadian musician whose work has been performed and recognized worldwide. Recent venues including the Great Wall of China and the White House. Graduate of UBC and the University of Toronto, Emery is a member of the Canadian Music Centre and the Canadian League of Composers. Through the honesty of the music and the comfort of the words, we hope you enjoy our performance of this lovely song.
Sweet.
Hi there, my name is Mano. I'm in my second year of the music diploma program here at GPRC, which I'll be completing this year. I'm both happy and a little sad, kind of like this next piece that I'm going to introduce to you, which is called A la Clara Fontaine. It is a French-Canadian folk song that is familiar to most French-speaking children in Canada. This simple melody was sung by generations well before our grandfather's time, dating back to the 1600s, where it is said that it would have been sung by the explorers of Champlain. It is a relic of the French-Canadian heritage. The lyrics employ vivid imagery of nature, such as spring waters, oak tree, rosebush, and a nightingale singing. Though beneath all that positive imagery is the story of a lost friendship. Perhaps this folk song will be familiar to you. If not, its simple melody is sure to stick with you long after this show. Enjoy.
Thank you.
GPRC, the next song we will be doing is Bring Me Little Water Sylvie. It is an old American folk song originally popularized by Hootie Leadbetter, better known as Leadbelly. The actual origins of the tune is unknown, but it was one of the many old American songs that Leadbelly brought to the masses. Leadbelly would historically tell the audience he was playing for that the song was about his uncle Bob Leadbetter. After long days plowing the field, he would call for his wife Sylvie to go fetch him some water. This particular arrangement is by Morris Smiley. She also choreographed the body percussion, which you will see in a moment.
Scott Flewelling. I'm a first-year student in the Music Diploma program. This next piece is called Wood Smoke and Oranges. It was originally written by Ian Tamblyn. The version we're singing is arranged by Rebecca Campbell. This song has been described thematically as being about surrendering to nature. As it was written by a Canadian songwriter, this offers a perspective about surrendering to nature as we are most familiar with it, the Canadian wilderness.
Days of sun and wind. Our last piece is a traditional Irish blessing text put to words by well-known Canadian composer Bob Chilcott. The original author of this blessing is unknown, although several historians attribute it to St. Patrick as it is similar to several of his other writings. Originally written in the Irish language, the prayer has three main images: wind, sun, and rain. These images speak to how God interacts with his people through nature. This blessing imprints onto us the strength of the ancient Irish's deep connection to both nature and religion. We hope you enjoy.